thanks to Catherine for being here.
We at Under Armour don't do anything without our athletes, so I'm glad to have Catherine on the stage with me to talk a little bit about connected fitness, or what we is called FitnessTech, but what we call connected fitness. One thing you'll learn about Under Armour is y'all just clapped a little bit. It's early in the morning. It's Vegas. It was probably late last night before you went to bed. But given that this is about sport and we are who we are, we like to start things with a little bit of energy. So before I get into talking about who we are at Under Armour and why we're here and some of the products that we're launching, and then giving Catherine a chance to talk a little bit about as an athlete, how she thinks about the things that we're doing and how it relates to the average athlete out in the world. I'd like to just give you a sense for who Under Armour is, and for us, the best way to do that is with a little bit of video. So let me start with that.
I believe they're the best in the game. They're aggressive, young, fearless.
The success just getting started. Oh.
Under Armour.
We're the cool kids.
The culture there is
aggressive, young, and fearless.
We're gonna shock the world.
The culture of our company is really about winning.
I'm so passionate about winning. I love it so much.
I just started kicking y'all's butts. Y'all should be embarrassed.
That guy from Under Armour,
he's gonna beat Nike's ass.
The champ is here! The champ is here!
It's a championship, baby.
It's another day in the office again.
Love the enthusiasm, but it's a little distracting.
Win one MVP.
Tell us what happened out there.
I'm not saying I'm the Taylor Swift of boxing, but I'm not saying I'm the Taylor Swift of boxing.
Girly girls.
In the backfield. New quarterback.
Besserman! El querido de Alessandro! ¡Vuela que vuela!
All the way around the world to see the MVP.
Konnichiwa.
We see amazing opportunity for us around the globe.
Under Armour. Under Armour. See?
No, man, it's Under Armour.
Weiter, komm!
First things first, we the realest. And we about to make the whole world feel it. Reaching on down, yeah, gear rock, yeah. You falling under arm over Nike. Under arm over Nike.
Oh! Listen up.
You cannot bet against UA.
Under Armour's a modern success story.
Today's Under Armour Day.
Put my Under Armour's on. Be ready to go. Go.
If the shoe.
If the shoe.
That was nasty.
In the face of overwhelming odds, I'm left with only one option. I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this.
The new UA record.
Yes, science!
Times are changing, Betty. These nerds are a threat to our way of life.
We're doing all the things.
All of a sudden, small ain't so small. So small.
We've talked about slaying giants before. This ain't no more David Goliath.
I told you it was better with the sound. So that's how we like to get our day started. This is a thing we call the house report. We put this together every once in a while just to give ourselves a sense for what's going on at Under Armour. And I hope this gives you a feel for what it is our brand is about. And there are a couple of really interesting messages as you look through that. If I showed you that house report even 3 years ago, you would see a lot less. There would be a lot less discussion about science. There would be a lot less discussion about fitness. There would be a lot less discussion about technology. There wouldn't be as many sports involved. There wouldn't be as broad a type of athlete involved. So the really awesome thing about for myself watching that video is just seeing how the brand has been able to expand and grow even in the last couple of years. And it's the reason that we believe we are here on this stage and that we believe we have a right to play in the fitness tech space and more broadly than fitness tech in connected fitness and connected health over time. Let me tell you a little bit more about why that is. You all know us for our athletes. Everyone probably has seen this picture. You know, we're a little bit proud of 2015. Small fact that we're pretty proud of is that all of the American sports MVPs, football, hockey, baseball, etc., are Under Armour athletes in 2015. The MLB MVP is an Under Armour athlete. Tom Brady, Under Armour athlete. And we think, by the way, the NFL MVP this year, Cam Newton, we think he'll be the MVP as well, and he's an Under Armour athlete. But you know us by these. Everyone knows us by these athletes, and they think about us in that very specific way. And what I would say to you is that we are much more than that. Importantly for us, we're a company that's driven by a mission, and it's a mission that is about making all athletes better. And as we've expanded as over the last 20 years, as we've gotten bigger and we've gotten better, we've expanded that definition of athletes to encompass a far, far larger set of people and a far, far larger set of activities. But at the core of it, we are a mission-driven company driven by the mission to make all athletes better. In addition to that, we have a vision. Our vision is to empower athletes everywhere, to put the tools and the technology in the athlete's hand, in their control, give them the data, the insight, the knowledge, the know-how, to let them achieve the goals that they have set for themselves, to unencumber them from constraints. So the mission is to make all athletes better. The vision is to really empower athletes, put the control in their hands. And 20 years ago, when we started, we really focused very much on this compression t-shirt. It was about making or changing the way that athletes dress, giving them equipment in terms of dressing that allowed them to play better on the field, on the pitch, on the court. But as we turn the page now for our next 20 years, we intend to change the way that athletes live. We intend to change the way that they live their lives in terms of what they're putting into their bodies, what they're doing with their bodies, what training they're doing, what activities is going on with them. So we are physically, literally changing, turning the page and taking our focus from changing the way athletes dress to changing the way they live. Very, very expansive, broad vision as we step into the future. And the vision for that started about 3 or 4 years ago, 2010, I guess 5, 6 years ago now, holy smokes, with the shirt that you see in this video. And there's a guy, that Cam Newton guy again, who came out in the NFL Combine this year. And you see that shirt that these guys are wearing. And in the center, there's a little bug. We call it a bug. It's a little with an Under Armour logo. And it all started with Kevin Plank, our founder, taking an original compression shirt, the one you saw a few slides ago, and saying, electrify this shirt. And we didn't really know what that meant. We knew that we had to be in digital. We knew that we had to make our shirts, quote unquote, electric. And at the time, while we wouldn't have said it this way, we'll say it now, we believe that every item of clothing that you wear, every shoe, every shirt, every accessory that you wear is going to be smart. The smarts might only be to tell you that I'm a size large, blue, and this is my SKU number so that you can find me when you're doing inventory in a retail store, but the smarts also may be biometric data that's coming off that can be used by the athlete. But every item, every article of clothing that you wear, we think will be very, very smart, and we don't think that future is very far away, and we believe we started that about 5 or 6 years ago when we invented this first shirt, which, by the way, still does exist. You can still use it at the Combine. Never became a commercial product for us because, not surprisingly from a consumer perspective, that shirt is very hard to wash. It's hard to put electronics in the wash. It doesn't last very long after you get it out of the washer and dryer. But it is a mission that we're on in terms of taking that shirt and making it a real commercial reality for the athlete because, as I said, we believe all shirts and shoes, every piece of clothing you put on your body will have some intelligence in it in the not too distant future. Because that shirt was hard to make from a commercial perspective, we took a slightly different path. We decided that we needed to get closer to the community, and over the last 24 months, we've done a couple of acquisitions. Starting with MapMyFitness in 2013, and then with Endomondo 2014 and 15 was MyFitnessPal, to build the world's largest digital health and fitness and connected fitness community. The largest, by far, 157 million people. Just yesterday, we had 192,000 people who registered, not downloaded, more than that downloaded, but registered on one of those four apps yesterday. Today, it'll be closer to 200,000 people. So every day, that 157 million is growing by about 200,000 people. That gives us a lot. It gives us a lot of data, it gives us a lot of insight, it gives us a lot of knowledge, and it gives us a lot of direction. And one of the things that we learned when we, as we kind of got into this over the last 24 months, is that, I'm gonna pause for a second, I forgot about this slide. It's an open community as well. So we have 50 plus partners, 400 plus devices. So we're not telling that the community members that they're locked into Under Armour. We're saying you're in the Under Armour community, but it's open to all devices, and we have many, many partners on the community. But what I was gonna get to was one of the things we learned as we talked to those 200 million people, or 160 million people, excuse me. When you talk to them about their fitness, they quickly start expanding the discussion. They start talking about their health, and they talk about their wellness. And as we talked to them about that, one of the things that we realized and we discovered, and it was really a sort of a, it wasn't an aha moment, but it was a process of discovery that over time what we realized is that people know a heck of a lot more about things like their car, things like their what's in their bank account, than they actually do know about their health. People know, hey, I went for a run the last 3 days, or I did yoga for the following 4 hours, or they know that I tracked this amount of food in this separate app. People know about pieces of their life, but they don't really know very much about their health. And in fact, you only really know about your health when you visit the doctor. Maybe you do an annual exam, maybe you don't, when you have a problem. And we know a lot more about our car. We know a lot more about the tire pressure and the oil type and the last time we put gas in it and how much we spend on maintenance a year. We know all those things about our car, which is, you know, a $20,000 or $30,000 investment. But we don't really know very much about our health. And what we found as we made the investment in our community is that while we had snippets and people had little pieces and little pieces of the picture, nobody really had a full view of what their health is. What we also learned is that when you talk to people about health and what it means to them, and we talked to doctors, we talked to nurses, we talked to, you know, average people, there were four things that kept coming up over and over and over again. There's a fifth thing that comes up as well, which I'll get to in a second, but at the end of the day, what we discovered is that sleep, fitness, activity, and nutrition, those were the four elements that people talked about when they talked about their health. When they said, I'm feeling good or bad, well, did I get enough sleep, or I'm not really moving around very much, or I didn't get my workout in, or I'm really overeating, like those four elements came up again and again and again. And so we took that feedback for ourselves and said, okay, if we start thinking about health as Under Armour, we have to anchor on those four things. The fifth thing that comes up fairly often as well is their mindset, mental state, how am I feeling? And so from those couple of insights, we rebuilt this product called Under Armour Record. So you guys probably remember, or maybe you don't, but we certainly do, not surprisingly. Last year at the same exact time, we launched the first Under Armour app. After we had done the acquisitions, we launched the first Under Armour app called Under Armour Record. And it was the first way for us to really integrate the 24/7 clock. So you could see on a single 24/7 clock, you could see your steps, you could see if you had a workout, et cetera. But based on what we had learned about how people talk about their health and the fact that they didn't have a holistic view, that they didn't have one place to go to really put it all together, we decided to redo Record. We decided to relaunch it, and we decided to relaunch it around these four elements, which is sleep, fitness, activity, and nutrition. And then as you see on the bottom there, it says, there's a little button that says, how do you feel? And that was, for us, a really critical piece, because obviously we're not the mental health expert. We don't intend to be, we don't hope to be, we don't aspire to be. That's not where our capability is. But what we knew is that if we really wanted to capture how people thought about health, we needed to have a way to capture how they felt about how they feel. Feel being a sort of mental state, a qualitative thing. And so we created this button on the bottom, which allows you to basically on every given day, to, in addition to capturing all this cool data, to qualitatively describe how you feel, and then to add some notes, which over time we'll be able to add more to. The other really fun thing is that, I don't know if everyone's downloaded Record or not, you probably have at this point, I'm sure you have actually, is when you use the How Do You Feel button, you'll see that the color and the brightness and the sharpness of the screen actually changes depending on how you feel. So if you go towards the one, the day becomes gray and blurry. If you go towards the 10, it becomes bright and vibrant and sharp as a reinforcement mechanism to the mental state. So at the end of the day, we refaced Record, we rebuilt it from scratch to create the daily dashboard, to give the average person, the 160 million people in our community, a chance to see their day, how it was at a glance, anchored on the four pillars, sleep, fitness, activity, nutrition, Weight is in there as well. It's hidden behind the button. We know people are sensitive about their weight, but if you touch that Under Armour logo in the center, your weight will come up, and then it will disappear after a few seconds. And then how do you feel? So a single dashboard to see health or your day in one picture. The other things that are available to it is that it's very shareable. So I can give personalized access to my doctor, my coach, my trainer, my family. There's obviously a follow and friend model in here as well. So I can have lots of friends, but I can restrict to a very, very select set of people some of these elements to very specific folks. So we thought it was really important after we had built the community and after we had learned what we learned to build this daily dashboard, to redo what record was. The other thing we learned was that it's really hard to collect all that data. So the way that we learned is, frankly, is there were about the top 30, 35 executives on Under Armour right after we had bought MapMyFitness in 2013. We set up a challenge for those top 35 execs, and we said, okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna give everybody a wearable, we're gonna give them a scale, and we're gonna give them the heart rate monitor, and we're gonna give them the then launched Under Armour record, and we're gonna create this challenge, and we're gonna see who burns the most calories in 35 days. And these are, you know, we're not the smartest people in the world at Under Armour, but you know, we're relatively accomplished. And to a person of the 30 people, not a single one of them could connect all three of those devices without IT support. Right, it's funny, but that's actually what we're sort of selling to consumers today. Our devices, if you actually wanted to track your steps and your sleep and your weight and get inactivity or in fitness data, to connect it and get it all back into one place, you need an IT person. The average person, the average guy on the street, not some super smart computer engineer or computer scientist or rocket scientist coming out of MIT or Stanford or Carnegie Mellon, but the average guy or gal living on the street who's just trying to drop 10 pounds, and you said, hey, here's the devices, here's the hardware that we keep selling you as a companies that you need to get to that 10-pound goal, and here's a way to capture and put it all in one place, good luck. You can't do it. It's just simply not easy. And so that inspired us to build this thing we called HealthBox, to build the system and create hardware designed as a system. And it's not a huge insight necessarily in the technology community. We know that really tightly integrated hardware and software, really tightly integrated components are much easier for the consumer. It's much easier for them to figure it out. They're not rocket scientists, they're average folks. And so we decided to build HealthBox so that we had hardware designed as a system. One simple, integrated software hardware. So as I said earlier, the community is open, absolutely open to anyone, but we think that we owe the consumer, if we want to give them a simple, easy way to look at their health, we owe them, we have an obligation. Our job is to make all athletes better and to empower them. We owe them an easy hardware solution to collect the data. We have to take the friction out of the system. If we hope to allow them to really see their health, we have to take the friction out. Taking the friction out means making the technology easy, which is really hard for us technology folks because we love our features and functions. But when you just go back to like, what is the guy or gal sitting on the couch really wanting to do? They're not sitting around waiting to buy the next wearable. They're not sitting around saying, I can't wait to put a heart rate strap on. I can't wait to stand on that scale. What they're sitting around saying is, I wish I were a little healthier. Boy, if I lost 10 pounds, I'd feel really good about that. I wish I could fit in those jeans. I want to look like what I looked like when I was in high school. Like, that's what they want. That's the goal. And our job is to help them achieve that goal, not to sell them a bunch of stuff, which we have to do, but to actually help them achieve the goal. They don't care that they walk 10,000 steps. They really don't care that they walk 10,000 steps. What they care about is, did I get healthier? Did I lose 10 pounds? Can I run faster? That's what they care about. So we built this system that allows them to do it. We integrated it, and we worked with HTC to build a really tight integration. So what you get is you get a wearable that allows you to track your activity, to track your sleep. It allows you to start fitness activity right there from the band. A heart rate strap, because as much as everybody wants to do heart rate straps on the wrists, it's just not as accurate in a workout. And if you're really doing heart rate training, which we believe is really important, accuracy is critical and it has to be on the chest. And then the scale, which allows you to see it all. It gets you the weight, gets you the body fat, and then it allows us to push notifications. The other beautiful thing that's inside of this this system is on the right. You can see there you got your daily dashboard in record. Is we've also built in partnership with IBM some really cool insights that come out of the engine. So we're giving back to the athletes as well. In addition to that system, we built this shoe. We built a shoe that's smart as well. And the beautiful thing about the shoe is, I don't know if there are any runners in here, but when you run today, you probably have to get your phone out and you want to track your run or you want to know like how far you ran. You got to put a big GPS watch on and stand around. Hopefully it captures it for you for about 30 seconds or a minute or two, depending on where you are. If you're in a city, it's 3 or 4. We built a shoe that has embedded technology that you just go for a run. Just put them on and you go for a run. And if you're going over a pace of 11 minutes a mile, it starts to collect the data. And then when you come back and close to your phone or close to your app, it automatically uploads the data. So the shoe now is just lets you run, lets you go back to what you wanted to do. It doesn't say I have to get my phone, I want my technology. It says I wanted to go for a run and I want to know how far I ran, I want to know what my pace was, I want to know what my splits were. This is the shoe that allows you to do that. You don't have to worry about where's your phone or where's your wearable or anything. Just put your shoes on and you go for a run. So we built the Gemini 2 to allow you to do that. And then everybody needs music when they're working out. So and everyone hates the cords hanging off them. So we worked with our partners at Harman JBL to build a wireless sport headphone so that you can remove the wires and you can still get the music that you want. And the cool product that you see on the right there, the one that we're really excited about, doesn't come out for a couple months now, is the wireless heart rate headphone. So that heart rate strap that a lot of folks don't like to wear for some reasons, we think we can at some point in the future replace that with just as accurate a heart rate, but in the ear. So you get your music and you get your heart rate without the strap. So we're pretty excited about this whole set of products. And as I said, it's designed as a system. We didn't sit down and say, hey, we have to build product A and product B and product C. We said we have to help athletes get better. We have to help them be healthier. And the way to do that was to take all the friction out of the system or as much as we can, first with a really tightly integrated app and hardware system that puts all the pieces together and then allows them to go for run or workout and capture that data in a frictionless way. So at the end of the day, as I said, we're turning the page. We've been around 20 years now. This is our 20th year here at Under Armour. We're going from changing the way athletes dress to changing the way they live. We're going to do that with a lot of big partners. We can't do this alone, and we assume that that's true for many folks here. We have an open community that allows our users to attach to lots of hardware. As we build our own technology platform, we're going to work with folks like HTC, folks like IBM, folks like Harman, because we cannot do this alone. We won't solve the consumer's problem, which is what we're really here for, without great partners. And ultimately, we have to build amazing products. And amazing products, in our view, are the simplest products. Again, the ones that remove the friction, that give the athlete what they really want, which is to capture the data without having to have a degree in computer engineering. And then we're going to leverage the world's largest health and fitness community. That 160 million people and growing, we think, is a really big deal, and we're going to continue to drive that into really important places. We're going to leverage the data off of that in ways that will help us build better products, that will help us build better experiences, and will help our athletes be better again. And as it said in the end of the video, we're just getting started. We're pretty excited about what we're doing. This is, we've been at this show in really full force 2 years now. This is our second big year. We started with Electrify the Shirt 4 or 5 years ago. It's still early days. We're still a baby. We have so much to learn. We have so much to do. Our industry, fitness tech, connected fitness, is in its infant stages. And at some point, every shirt, every shoe will be smart. We are absolutely convinced of that. And we intend to play a very big role in being a part of that. So that's the Under Armour story. That's what we're doing, and that's the products we launched.